Again, so we are discussing about the corpus denier. For the competitive examinations, again, we can expect one more important question. In the case of corpus deniers, I am talking about two publications of corpus deniers, one is Species Pandara, another one is Systema Naturae. So you can write one more poem, which is the first publication of Carolus Linnaeus, okay, the first publication of, okay, the first publication, which is the first book or the first publication of Carolus Linnaeus. Anybody, can you say, which is the first publication of Carolus Linnaeus? You can note the poem or you can note the book name, the first publication of Carolus Linnaeus. His name is what? Hortus. Okay. Hortus Aplanticus. Okay. Hortus Aplanticus. You can note the another book wrote by Carolus Linnaeus, written by Carolus Linnaeus. His name is what? Hortus Aplanticus, which is considered as one of the first publication of Carolus Linnaeus. Listen, not only these three publications, again there are many publications regarding about our water, Carolus Linnaeus. You can note one more poem. Listen, again we can expect one question. The publication of Carolus Linnaeus, which laid foundation to ICBN. Are you heard about ICBN? That is what? Yes, you are right on. That is International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. That means it is a collection of rules. ICBN, International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. This is a collection of rules. That rules and regulations only we are following while we are giving scientific names to, while we are giving binomial names to plants. I told you, the person who considered as the father of binomial nomenclature, that is the Carolus Linnaeus. So again, we can expect a question, the publication of Carolus Linnaeus, which laid the foundation to what? ICBN. That means most of the rules present in ICBN is took from the publication of Carolus Linnaeus. Please, what is it? Anybody? Anybody can say, listen, listen, no need to waste our time. So you can note the publication, again you can note the poem, that is publication, what which lie the foundation, okay, the publication which lie the foundation to what, that is really important, which lie the foundation to, you can note ICBN, which stands for, or which is known as what? I stands for International. C stands for Code. International Code for Botanical Nomenclature. Okay, Botanical, International Code for Botanical Nomenclature. International Code for Botanical Nomenclature. What is ICBN means? You can know, sir. It is a collection of, it consists of, it is collection of rules as well as what regulations, the collection of rules and regulations. And ICBN, again, you can know that it is first time the ICBN established, okay, the ICBN established in the year. Anybody? Actually, you don't know the publication of Carolus Linnaeus, which laid the foundation to ICBN. Now, I am asking another question. Can you say the year of establishment of ICBN? Anybody? Any re-repeaters? Listen, the year of establishment, the first ICBN establishment in the year 1961.
And listen, 1961 year or the year 1961 in which ICBM is established, and you have not one more point you may know, in the year 1978. The 1978, it is last published, okay, last published in the year 1978. What is last published? The rules and regulations presenting the ICBM, that is International Code for Botanical Nomenclature, which modified again in the year 1978 and which published in the year, or last published in the year 1978. We are discussing about what? We are discussing about the Carolus Linnaeus. Can you understand me? So listen, these are the important points you have to know. Not only these, you can ask the two more important points regarding Carolus Linnaeus. Two more important points regarding Carolus Linnaeus. This person, that is Carolus Linnaeus, who also published one more classification. Okay, what is two different system of classification? One more important classification he proposed, that means he was also considered as the father of, considered as father of sexual system of classification. Sexual system. He was also considered as the father of sexual system of classification. Isn't sex means nothing? Something related with the sex organs. Yes or no? Sexual reproduction is the? Yes, sexual reproduction is the. Sexual reproduction means the reproduction which involves the fusion, formation and the fusion of male and female gametes. Following zygote formation, embryo development, with embryo development or without embryo development. So, he was also considered as the father of sexual system. Why he was considered as the father of sexual system means nothing. He also proposed about classification. Majorly in the case of angiosperms, he classified angiosperms into different classes based on what are the sex organs. Sex organs means, I think you are very familiar, male sex organ is known as stamen. So, female sex organ is known as what are carpal or pistil. Male sex organ together known as androecium. Female sex organ is together, entire female sex organ is known as gynecium. So he majorly classified it, that is what the angiosperms, into different groups based on their sex organ. What sex organ? Majorly based on, okay, majorly based on what the number of stamens. That means whether the flower consists of a one stamen, whether the flower consists of a two stamen. For example, he given the names like, for example, flower which consists of only one stamen, he given the name as monandria. Monandria, mono one, andria, andrasium. Two stamen in a flower is present there, that contributes, he given a name diandria, di, two, andria, andrasium. Three stamen, triandria, like that he given the names for a particular group of plants which consists of only a particular number of stamens. That's why the classification is known as sexual system, mainly based on what the number of stamen, where the stamens will be present, number of stamens or the stamens are present in. He majorly classified that plants into water based on their sex organs into water sexual system, majorly into how many classes? 24 classes. He majorly classified the plants based on their sex organ into how many classes? 24 classes. Important. Listen, you have to note that
This is the reason behind it why it is known as Pavlov's sexual system of classification, or the person who published the sexual system of classification, why it is known as sexual system of classification, how many classes have you divided, or are important for our examination. My last and the core point, you have to know this sexual system, okay, this sexual system of classification is published through, okay, is not published through species Ferrara, or not published through system analysis, not published through Horthos, Aplantigans. The sexual system of classification proposed by Carolus Linnaeus, and he published that classification through another doctor who his name is what? Which you cannot, his name is what? You cannot hear, his name is Genera Plant, which, yeah, you can know. So what is Genera Plantara means? What is the Genera Plantara? Be the publication of Carolus Linnaeus, through which Carolus Linnaeus published the sexual system of classification, that is classification of plants into 24 classes, based on their sex organs or number of sex organs, majorly stamens are concerned. So please, we can take up to this important points in the case of what are important point in the case of Carolus Linnaeus. First, you can take, please. So listen, here I am told you now one important poem, that is ICBN stands for International Code for Botanical Nomenclature, and another one poem you have to note that opposite to ICBN, one more item here which gives the binomial names to other plants, that I am already told you, opposite to that, one more thing is that you have to know what is ICBN. It is stands for what? International Code of International Code for, okay, International Code for Zoological Nomenclature, okay, Zoological Nomenclature, important. Can you understand me? One A stands for International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, and another one A stands for what? International Code for Zoological Nomenclature. That is International Code for Zoological Nomenclature, which will give what? I guess there are binomial names to animals. Binomial, for example, I can say that, for example, cow, okay, cow, its binomial name is, you cannot hear, that is what, Bos indica, okay, Bos indica, binomial name of what, cow. Like this, for example, binomial name of cat is the, that is what the character is, binomial name is Felis domestica. Okay, binomial name is Felis domestica. Like that, the binomial name is not only applicable in the case of animals, this also applicable in the case of the plants also. So we are giving binomial names for both the plants and animals for avoiding confusions. So this code will be divisible to other animal nomenclature or binomial nomenclature. That point also you have to note. Next, ICBN. You can note one more thing, that is what ICNCP is, okay,
ICNCP. What is ICNCP? I think you are very familiar about ICBM. Very familiar about what IC second. So you should know about what is IC second. ICNCP. You can order. This is the code which gives provide or which provide binomial names to what cultivated plants. Cultivated plants means, for example, within rice there are 1000 species of rice varieties are there. Yes, no? Within mango, mandifera indica, there are hundreds or thousands of mango varieties are there. Like many cultivated plant species are there, many crop varieties are there. The binomial names to the newly developed crop varieties are given by that is our ICNCP. Please, I am asking now, can you say, anybody can you say what is stands for ICNCP and its full? Yes, sir. Very good. You can note what is ICNCP. You can note the nearest water. This is international. Okay, this water international. And C stands for coda. C coda for what? Nomenclature. Okay, international coda for nomenclature of water plants, cultivated plants. Okay, cultivated plants. International course of nomenclature of cultivated plants. What is ICNCP? Which provide binomial names to water. Which provide binomial names to crop varieties. Can you understand me? So that point also you have not when we are discussing different code. Not only this ICNCP, there is also what can be present ICNB. Okay, ICNB. Anybody can you say what is ICBN is different? ICNB I am discussing. ICNB. Again, you can note the same one. International, I stands for international code. Okay, C stands for code. For what? International code of nomenclature. Okay, code for nomenclature. For what? International code of nomenclature for bacteria. Please. Can you understand me? International Code of Nomenclature for Bacteria. International Code of Nomenclature for Bacteria. That is our water. ICNP. You can note again the last one. You can also note ICBN. So ICBN again, I am not interested to write again the same thing. So International Code for Water. International Code for Water Nomenclature. International Code for Viral Nomenclature. Okay, Viral Nomenclature. That means this is the agency which provide names or the scientific names regarding about virus. I think nowadays we are very familiar about the technical term virus. That is our coronavirus or the pandemic which is spread all over the world, that is as a COVID-19. We have more than 150 countries. We are till now we are also affecting too many about these or due to these coronavirus. So actually virus is living or not living, anybody can say whether it is living or not living. That is living, not living. It is actually, we can't say whether it is living organism or non-living organism, but we can say one thing, there are some what infectious particles which consist of proteins and water, nucleic acid, maybe DNA or RNA, depends upon the virus. But when that virus is entered into the body of living organism, which has gained the property or which gained the characteristic of a living organism. That's why this virus, once entered into the body of living organism, not only in the case of human beings, in the case of some animals also, in the case of some plants also, the plants also affected by certain viruses like tobacco mosaic viruses, aloe mosaic viruses, like the different viruses are affected by plants also. So here you have to know that your virus means not a living, not a non-living, but when they enter into the living organism, which gains the characteristic of a living organism, so the virus having certain living characters, they have some certain water, non-living characters also. So this is the ICVN, which stands for water, International Code for Water Nomenclature, viral nomenclature. So this is, you cannot declare water, one is the zoological nomenclature, one is the nomenclature for cultivated plants, one is the nomenclature for bacteria, one is the nomenclature for water, viral nomenclature. Can you understand me? Can you understand me? So, out of these four nomenclature, you should remember about what ICNCP, then IC said then. What is the reason behind it? IC said then, ICNCP, and here you have to remember about what ICB. And you can also, I am told you, this is about viral nomenclature. There are different nomenclatures there. Out of that, publication of coronavirus in AS, which likely foundation to ICVN, that is our water, ICVN, that is our, it's a publication. Anybody? It's a publication. Genera, Prangara. No? Orthosubclandicus. No, what is the publication? Its name is water. This name is anybody? The publication of Carolus is like the foundation to ICVN. You can note a very, very important the publication, which like the foundation to ICVN. What is Philosophica Botanica? Okay, Philosophica Botanica. What is Philosophica Botanica? Is the publication of Carolus Linnaeus, water, which again I am saying, it's a lighter water, it's a lighter water, it's lighter foundation to water, foundation to ICBN. Not ICNB, that is ICBN. You can note that one also. It is also very, very important for our final preparation. So, five publications: one is Species Matter, Systema Naturae, Philosophica Botanica, Genera Prangara, and the other one is our water, Hortus Atlanticus. These Philosophica Botanica published in the year 1751. So, please, you can take these entire things, they are very important for your examination. Thank you.